of mine. Nigeria on my mind. Born in diversity, blessed beyond compare.
Tonight has been a night for Goodluck, Jonathan, and the agenda about the development in Nigeria. So what do you think about this night?
You know what? I will give God the glory. This night shows our future. This is not a night for us, parents or adults. This is a night for the young adults. Can you imagine Mama sitting down, taking a back seat for the first time? You know, Mama is always agitated. Now, and watch your generation and your generation yet unborn under the president, Goodluck, Jonathan. You know,
this land of mine,
this land of mine,
Nigeria.
So what do you think, in as much as Mama Ende, you see how well she spoke about, you know, striving so hard, gaining some things for the people of Nigeria, because she's not only working for the older people, but for the younger generation, as she's been mentioning. So what do you think about all these things that has been mentioned this evening?
Well, you know, Mama has a very energetic energy. She's very driven. And when you come around her, you're bound to catch some of that spirit. But she called me and said I should come. I came, and incidentally, we didn't have the time to go through the panel session, which was the session I was supposed to moderate. But I'm glad I'm here to see what happened, and I will continue to do the best I can on my own to further the advancement of the Nigerian agenda.
Okay, so based on everything that has been mentioned, how do you see, or what will you say about Goodluck, Jonathan, running for 2015?
Oh, I went through the two-year, the material for the two-year program here, and it's quite impressive. And you know, no one is perfect, but if you see someone who's doing well, you should encourage that person. I think he's doing well. There are areas that can be amended, but also there are a lot of areas to be commended. So to the best of my ability, I will try to encourage and try to support what I think is good for Nigeria.
A brighter and better days.
Analyze to say he's fit for 2015.
Well, so far, so good. He's doing a good job. I'm part of the Goodluck support group. And by the way, my name is Henry Okazu, and I'm the PRO for the Nigerian Lawyers Association. I'm also part of the Goodluck support group right here in USA. Goodluck has done a good job. Let's look about the power reform in Nigeria. He has transformed that sector. The agri sector has been reformed and revamped. Now the racism in Nigeria has been reformed and revamped, and then Nigerian diaspora are now investing in Nigeria. So all things being good, being equal, I think he's doing a good job, and I'm thinking 2015 he's going to have a good number of supporters on that particular day.
What do you think about this night?
I'm really glad that I became part of this. You know, I'm really not into politics, but having to know who Jonathan is and the good things that he's been doing for Nigeria, I'm really a supporter right now. Jonathan has been very selfless, you know. This is the first time I've ever seen a president who really don't think of himself, but working for the nation.
That's so wonderful. You know, because I know you in the movie industry, and the beck and call all tonight that I've been hearing is everybody needs to be a part to make Nigeria, you know, whatsoever the government is doing, a success. So what do you think? What's one advice that you could give to everybody that's in the movie industry? Based on what has been said today, what do you think you need to tell your people in the movie industry how to get involved in the Nigerian government?
Really, we've already been involved even before now. You see some of the Nollywood stars taking up position, you know, taking up governmental posts, getting involved in politics, and being that Jonathan also is a very active person in the Nollywood. You know, financially he's helped Nollywood a lot for the first time. So we are part of him, and we definitely going to support him come 2015.
We have been here, we spent looking at videos and listening to speeches of things that has been done in Nigeria. Mm-hmm. How proud are you to talk about what this man, Mr. Goodluck Jonathan, has done for Nigeria?
Oh, I'm very, very proud of the work that the president of Nigeria has been doing. The work is with him. He didn't say the transformation agenda for nothing. It is a transformation agenda that has been moving Nigeria forward. And now for a lot of people, you know, a lot of us Nigerians who are here now and those who grew up in Nigeria, look, we remember the time when things were not going so well in Nigeria. So the president has not only done a wonderful job, but his work is not finished. So as Nigerians, I know most Nigerians, we are easy to criticize. And it's easy to criticize so long as what you are criticizing him for, right, is valid. I'll give you an example. NEPA, in 1914, we never really had electricity. Now, we still have some of that problem now, but the president is doing everything he can to fix that system as a result of the privatization. When you hear people speak, they'll think that the issue of electricity just started yesterday. You know, that's something that has been happening for so long. The president understands all those things and he's doing as much as he can to make sure that every Nigerian has power.
So the fundamental agenda, what do you think about it tonight? Mm-hmm.
Well, I think, you know, obviously we came together tonight to honor, you know, Goodluck Jonathan and what he's doing in his presidency. As a member of the state of New York, I'm looking for opportunities to partner with people globally who are doing great things. Obviously, I have a lot of Nigerians in my district that I represent in the 21st district in Brooklyn. And so this is a great event because there's a lot of networking, a lot of business opportunities that I think will be good for both the state of New York and the country of Nigeria. So I'm looking forward to, you know, great things happening from this.
Okay, as a senator within the district, what are you going to say to the Nigerians? Because from a foreign person to a Nigerian about their own country, say something to them that will really inspire them about what you learned today.
Oh, well, one of the things that I learned is that how much opportunity there is in Nigeria and how open the government is to doing business, and so I think that's going to be a great opportunity for all of us. And I think that people who are from Nigeria ought to reach out to me and suggest to me ways that the state of New York can partner with them to have good trade and good other good opportunities with Nigeria.
That you were the organizer for this wonderful event.
Thank you.
So, what was your thought putting this event together? And what was the motive, the aim and goal for this event?
I think for me, it was really about helping to evangelize all the great things that President Goodluck has been doing for Nigeria. And I think, you know, we as Nigerians in the diaspora, we owe it to ourselves to continue to become brand ambassador for the country as well as for the president, especially with the launch of the transformation agenda. I feel like this is the first time a president of a great country like Nigeria is really putting, really thinking about all the different sectors and the things that needs to change in those sectors and putting it in motion and making it, instilling it upon his administration to really deliver on there. So if you're a minister of finance, you have a responsibility to cultivate economy. So I was very proud to do this because of I'm a Nigerian and because I love the president. I love what he's doing for Nigeria.
That's so very good, so inspiring. Two things that were mentioned actually that were really emphasized on throughout this whole meeting. One was about, that really blew the mind of people, was the youth involvement.
Yes.
Because you know, you guys came together and put up a, you know, a video to show things that people might not even be thinking about.
Yeah.
And the second thing is that, you know, that wow the minds, and it was an encouragement actually. It's for more people rather to get involved instead of being a critic.
Right.
So as a young lady, right, I want you to share your voice to the younger people, the younger generation, because it was mentioned by all the speakers for people to get involved in politics.
Yeah.
So what is your advice to the people out there who are Nigerians to get involved in the Nigerian politics?
I think that, you know, I've coined this phrase that says, you know, sustainability can only exist when there's collaboration, participation, and accountability. You know, we have to have an invested interest in moving our country forward. And it's not just Nigeria, any country you're part of. You know, I'm part of the United States and I'm doing things to kind of cultivate growth within my own community. And now that I'm even a diaspora Nigerian, I'm also doing things to cultivate. So what I say is, find an issue, find an area that you're passionate about and do something. You know, take a voice in that. Nothing is little and nothing is big. You know, find out what's going on and be the ambassador, like I mentioned. Be the brand ambassador for the issues that you support and for the country that you come from.
I'm really humbled by this commendation, but it will continue to galvanize me to do more for my country and humanity.